Climate change is one of the modern challenges the world is currently grappling to address, and it's attracting billions of dollars in funding from both the public and private sector. However, information from industry players indicate that Africa received only 3% of the total global climate financing between 2000 and 2018, according to the director of EED Advisory, a Kenyan consultancy firm on climate change. The explanation is that even the small funding that comes to Africa ends up in the pockets of the Western organization stationed here.
A lot of money is coming from the West, but in order to ensure that our local organizations are able to absorb this funding, two things must happen. One is that there can be a lot of stringent conditions that are placed by foreign entities on the kind of local organizations that can receive financing. So an example, a very simple one, is do our local organizations have audited accounts? The answer is no. So the question is, do we bypass them? Or the question is, do we allow or give a type of technical assistance to them to ensure that 5 years from now, there will be organizations that keep these records, that can also be able to be accountable, be able to be transparent, and be able to bring forward the impact that they're already having on the ground.
Access to climate financing is one of the challenges that the MOT Foundation, a US-based organization, is spearheading to address through concerted efforts, the partnerships between strategic organizations. The targeted sectors include aquaculture, dairy, horticulture, and energy.
Interconnectedness and partnerships, I mean, that comes through, and you guys are all part of this collective, but you're also interconnected and partnered in your communities and with the groups that you're working with and entrepreneurs that you're working with. So it's just really wonderful to see the partners coming together and really driving local solutions for what is essentially a global problem. It was evident to me to see the vision and passion that you all bring to your work, and that is absolutely fundamental. I've been doing this work for a long time at the MOT Foundation.
Now, this meeting brings together what we call the dream partners within East Africa. It brings us, being the dream partner for Kenya. It brings the Wildlife Foundation, which is the dream partner for Tanzania. It brings in the Haifa International, which is the dream partner for Uganda, and then it brings the Innovation Village, which is an ecosystem partner supporting entrepreneurs.
Key among the challenges the organizations are seeking to address is the mismatch between available funding and what the local organizations can absorb.
Now, the third lesson we've learned over time is that finance alone will never be able to solve the challenge of climate entrepreneurship. You also need technical assistance, you need mentorship, you need a hand-holding of those ideas in order to be able to support. And then finally, you need partnerships in order to create the whole ecosystem.